Hello everyone, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to start or we are going to solve next problems in exercise 2. That is, next problem is problem number 29. So see the problem number 29. The copying charges for a sheet of paper is rupees 1.44. How many such sheets can be copied at the least so that the copying charges can be paid in full number of 50 paise coins? This problem is quite complicated. It's difficult to understand. So I'm reading again. See, the copying charges for a sheet of paper, one sheet of paper. See here, copying charges for a sheet of paper, one sheet of paper. Is what is rupees 1.44. That means for one sheet of paper, copying means Xerox, taking Xerox. Okay, so to Xerox one sheet of paper, we need rupees 1.44. Then the question is, how many such sheets can be copied at the least? At the least means minimum. Minimum, how many such sheets can be Xerox or copied so that the copying charges can be paid in full number of 50 paise coin. Now see here, we have to pay the charges in the form of 50 paise coin, right? So here, if you see the charge of one sheet of paper is 1.44. This is, can you pay this in the form of 50 paise coin? You know that 1 rupee, here 1.44 means 1 rupees and 44 paise. 1 rupees you can pay in the form of 50 paise coin. That is 50 plus 50, 100 paise. And 100 paise means 1 rupee, you know that. But 44 paise you cannot pay in the form of 50 paise coin, right? You will get something changed back, but we don't want that. We have to pay all the charges, whatever charges will be there, we have to pay in the form of 50 paise coin. Such minimum sheets, minimum, how many sheets can be copied, can be Xerox, that we have to find. Now in this example, they have not given how many sheets we have to copy or what is the total cost. They have not given. We have to find out by ourselves. That means here we need to use trial and error method. We have to keep on trying, but when we are going to use the trial and error method, we have to go in the proper direction. Now see, 50 paise coin, they have asked to pay all the charges in the form of 50 paise coin, right? That means what? Whatever charges we will pay, whatever amount we will pay, that amount should be in the form of this. Either after decimal point there must be 00, means here whole number should be there. Suppose there is 5, then 5, total 5 rupees should be there, or 5.50, there should be 50 at the end, after decimal there should be 50 or 00. Okay, this I have given for example. Okay, after decimal point there must be 00 or 50, then only it is possible to pay the charges in the form of 50 paise coins. Okay, that means what? See, suppose there is 5 rupees, then 5 times are 10, 10 50 paise coin, and this 0.50 means 50 paise, this one 50 paise coin, total 11 50 paise coin we will pay here. Okay, here 5.00 means exactly 5 rupees, that means we can pay that in the form of 50 paise coin. You know that 1 rupee means 2 50 paise coin, that means 5 rupee means 10 50 paise coin. Okay, so this, like this amount we have to find, like this amount we have to find by multiplying this copying charges of one sheet, that is rupees 1.44. Now see, when it is possible to get after decimal point 00 or 50, after decimal point 00 or 50, when it is possible by multiplying by which numbers it is possible? Can you guess? Yes, see here. To get 00 or 50, you know table of 5? See, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 25, 30, 35, and so on. If you see the table of 5, at the ones place of 5, there is ones place of all the numbers in table of 5, there is 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, right? So, here what we are going to do, we are going to multiply this copying charges of one sheet, that is rupees 1.44. We are going to multiply this by multiples of 5. We will keep on trying. Okay. So, see here. First of all, we will multiply first by trial and error method. You know, trial means try and error means mistakes. Try mistakes. But at one step, we will get correct answer. This is called trial and error method. So, first of all, we will multiply 1.44 by first multiple of 5, that is 5 itself. 5 fours are 20. 5 fours are 20 plus 2, 22. 5 ones are 5 plus 2, 7. See, here at the end, after decimal point, there is 20. And what we want? We want after decimal point either 00 or 50. Then only it is possible to pay the charges in the form of 50 paise coin. Okay. So here there after decimal point there is 20. So this is not possible. Let's multiply 1.44 by second multiple of 5. That is 10. 5 twos are 10, right? 10 fours are 40. 0 will come down, 4 will be carried. 10 fours are 40 and 4, 44. 4 will be carried. 10 ones are 10 and 4, 14. So, is it possible? 14.40. Is it possible to pay in the form of 50 paise coin? No. You will get yes. Change back. So, as there is 40 after decimal point. Okay. So, 10 sheets are also not possible. Then we will multiply 144 by 15. See, here we are multiplying now 5 by 10 or by 15. These are number of sheets. Work charges of one sheet is 1.44. Then if there are 5 sheets, then what amount we will get? If there are 10 sheets of paper, then what amount we will get? This is the amount. Okay. Now, if you multiply by 15 sheets, 15 fours are 60. 6 will be carried. Again, 15 fours are 60 plus 6, 66. 15 ones are 15 plus 6, 21. Okay. So, here also not possible because the after decimal point there is 60. We want 00 or 50. Let's multiply by next multiple of 5, that is 20. 24s are 80. 8 will be carried. 24s are 80 plus 8, 88. 8 will come down. 8 will be carried. 21s are 20 plus 8, 28. Is it possible? Is it possible to pay in the form of 50 paise coin? No, right? Let's multiply by the next multiple of 5, that is 1.44 into 25. 25 sheets. If there are 25 sheets of paper, then what amount we are getting? Let's see. 25 fours are 100. 10 carried. 25 fours are 110. 110. Okay, so 0 will come down. 11 will be carried. 25 ones are 25 and 11, 36. So, if you see here, when we multiply 1.44 by 25 sheets, we got total cost 36.00 and we want 00 or 50 at the after decimal point, right? So, this amount 36.00, this amount can be paid in the form of 50 paise coin. That is, you know that 1 rupee means 250 paise coin. Then 36 rupee means how many 50 paise coin? 36 twos are 72. Correct. So this amount we can pay in the form of 50 paise coin. Understood? So minimum how many sheets can be copied to pay the amount in the form of 50 paise coin? 25 sheets. Okay. So minimum 25 sheets. So, at least 25 sheets of paper can be copied. Understood this problem? Watch this 2 times. Okay. Pause this video, write in your notebook. Let's move towards. Let's solve question number 30. 9 was subtracted from 5,866. 9 was again subtracted from the remainder. If we continue this process, what would be the least remainder, which is an even number? How many times should 9 be subtracted to get the remainder? So see this problem, 9 was subtracted from 5,866, 9 was again subtracted. So here there is repeated subtraction of 9 and repeated subtraction of any number, again and again subtraction, that is repeated subtraction of same number is nothing but division, correct? So here there is repeated subtraction of 9 from 5,866. That means what here? We have to divide 5,866 by 9. We have to divide till we get the remainder, which is an even number. So we have to divide 5,866 and we have to find the remainder, which is an even number. Now what is mean by even number? Even number means nothing but the numbers having 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. This digit at their ones place, units place, okay. They are called even numbers. So we have to find remainder, which is an even number. Fine. So first of all, let's divide 5,866 and let's see what remainder we are getting. After dividing 5,866 by 9, if you are getting remainder even number, then okay. Okay. See, let's divide it. When we'll divide 5,866, 9 6 are 54. Remain 8 minus 4, remain 4, here 0. 6 down, 9 5s are 45. 6 minus 5, 1. 0. Let's bring 6 down. 9 ones are 9. 16 minus 9, 7. So here we have divided 5,866 by 9 and we got remainder 7. Okay. Now see, to get this remainder, we have subtracted 9 651 times. 651 times we have subtracted 9 from 5,866. At that time we got remainder 7. But is it even number? Is 7 an even number? No, it is not even number, it is odd number. We want the remainder, which is an even number. So here see, one step will go up. One step will go up. We will cut this step. 5,866 divided by 9. 9 for 6 are 54. 8 minus 4, 4, 0. Let's bring 6 down. 9, 5 are 45. 1 remain. 6 came down. Now see, we have to divide whole, all, means 5,866. Okay. Now see, here there is 16. If we get 16 as a remainder, then it is an even number. So first, we need to divide 16 by 9, but by which number we want remainder 16 again, then by which number we need to divide here again? 9 by 0. 9 zeros are 0. Now see, again 16 is a remainder. Why we have done like this? If we divide in our actual way, proper way, then we are getting remainder 7. It is an odd number, so we don't want odd number as a remainder. We want even number as a remainder, so we have done this arrangement. We divided 16 by 0 so that we get remainder 16 itself, which is an even number. Okay, so this is the remainder, the least remainder, which is an even number. And for to get this remainder, even number as a remainder, how many times we have subtracted 9 from 5866? 650 times. Understood? So do you know the quotient which we get? It is the number of subtraction we have done, number of times subtraction we have done here from 5866. We have subtracted 650 times 9. At that time we got remainder 16. Understood? So the least even the 16 is the least remainder, even remainder and 650 times 9 is subtracted. From 5866. Okay, understood? So pause this video and write in your notebook. We will solve next problems. Let's move towards the next question, that is question number 31. The product of three numbers is 23,828. If two of the numbers are 23 and 37, what is the third one? So there is product of three numbers. You know, product means what? Nothing but multiplication. So multiplication of three numbers is 23,828. Out of three, two numbers are given. One of the number is 23 and another number is 37. And third one number we have to find. So the third one number we don't know. So we'll consider it as a X. So let the third one number be x. It is unknown number. Okay, so we have to find, so we have considered it as a x. So x, or c, 23 multiply by 37 multiply by x is equal to what? 23,828. Okay, this is the multiplication product of these three numbers, 23, 37 and x. X means the unknown number. Third number is unknown. We don't know that. We have to find that. Okay, so how to find now? Two numbers are given, third one number is not given. How to find? What to do, you know? This 23 is multiplied here, right? We will divide this number by 23. Understood? We'll divide. See, we have seen transpose rule. This is equal sign, this is left hand side, this is right hand side. Okay. So this multiply by 23 will bring this side. So when 23 will come at this side, it will change its sign. There is multiplication, it will change into division. Okay, this is the transpose rule, rule of transposition. So first of all, we'll divide 23,000. So here it there will remain 37 into x is equal to 23,828. This 23 will bring here and it will be divided to this number. So 23,828 divided by 23. Let's divide it here. Let's 8 come down. 23 zeros are 0. Bring 2 down. 23 threes are 69. 12 minus 9, 3. 7 minus 6, 1. 23 threes are 69, 23 fours are 92, 115, 138. See, It is divisible. 23 in 6 are 138. So 23 6 are 138. Okay. So when we divided this number by 23, we got answer 1036. So 37 into x, 37 multiplied by x is equal to 1036. Okay. Now, as we have to find value of x, so x will keep at this side only, and this multiply by 37 we will bring here. Here there is 1036, and when 37 will come here, it will be divided to 1036. Okay, so 1036 divided by 37. Understood how 37 was multiplied to x? When it changed its side, it became divide. Now, why to change side? You understood? We have to find value of x. So all the numbers which are on this side, left hand side, we have brought here. Okay, and they are multiplied here. So when they came at this side, they became divide. So let's divide now 136 by, let's divide 1036 by 37. For this we need to prepare table of 37. So I have already prepared table of 37. 37 2s are 74, 37 3s are 111. So we'll take here 2s are 74. You prepare table of 37, okay? 13 minus 4, 9, and 9 minus 7, 2. Let's bring 6 down, became 296. 37 8s are 296. Okay. So answer is 28. So when we divide 1036 by 37, we got answer 28. So x is equal to 28. That means the third number which we have considered x, it is nothing but 28. So the third number is 28. So this 23,828, it is product of which three numbers? 23, 37 and 28. Understood? Let's solve next question. Question number 32. The largest two-digit number was added to a certain five-digit number. The result was the least six-digit number. What was the five-digit number? So here in this problem, we have to find that five-digit number. What was the five-digit number? We have to find it. So we will consider it as x. Let the five-digit number be 5x. Okay, let the 5 digit number be x. Now see, the largest 2 digit number was added. So first we need to find largest 2 digit number. Largest 2 digit number. Can you tell me which is largest 2 digit number? Which is that? 99. Largest two-digit number was added to a certain five-digit number, means when 99 was added in x, x means five-digit number, certain five-digit number, it is not largest or smallest, any five-digit number. So when 99 was added to x, we got the result was the least six-digit number. Now here, which is least six-digit number? Least means smallest six digit number, that is 100000. 1 lakh. Okay, 1 lakh is the least six digit number. So result was this. That means how will be the equation? X plus 99, means 99, which is the largest two digit number, was added in the certain five digit number. The result was 1 lakh, smallest six digit number. So x is equal to what? This plus 99. To find value of x, this plus 99 will bring here, right side of the equal sign. So now it is plus when it will come on this side, it will become minus 99. It will be subtracted from the 1 lakh. So when we'll subtract 99 from 1 lakh, let's do here. Zero minus nine not possible. So first zero will become 10, then 9, 9, 9, 9, and this zero. 10 minus 9, 1. Okay, 9 minus 9, 0. 99,901. So that 5-digit number is. So the certain 5-digit number is. Understood? Pause this video and write in your notebook.